So in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to set up Google Analytics on Redbubble. I also want to talk to you guys about why it's important to use Google Analytics. And the main aim of this video is to make sure that by the end of it, all of you guys know how to set up Google Analytics. If you're ready for this, please do drop a like, as that would be very much appreciated. And with that said, let's jump straight into it. Hi guys, my name is Phil and welcome to the Money Game YouTube channel. For anyone that's new around here, I make print-on-demand content to both motivate and to give you guys tips and tricks on how you can improve your print-on-demand shops. Now, if you do happen to be new around here and you haven't already, please do click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. That way, you won't miss out on any future videos. We've helped a lot of people to get their first online sales through sites like Redbubble. And if you yourself are looking for extra information on how to get started, down in the description, I actually have a free print on demand starter guide. However, if you're looking to turn this into more of a full-time thing, I also do have a paid step-by-step guide that's actually linked down below. So check that out if you are interested in it. But as for today, like I said, we're going to be talking about how to set up Google Analytics on your Redbubble stores. Now, before I jump into this, I just want to say I have covered a video on Google Analytics before, but since I made that video, things have now been updated, as you guys keep telling me in the comment section. So today I thought, why not give you guys an update on the new way to do it so you guys can actually get set up with this. So about a week ago, I actually put together a poll asking you guys if you use Google Analytics. Now, 48% of you guys said yes, but the majority either didn't know what it is or you said no, which is why I feel like it's very important I make this video, because Google Analytics is very, very important, especially if you're trying to do research in regards of which designs are doing well for you, which designs are getting you clicks to allow you to better your shop. Anyways, I'll be talking about this more throughout this video. And there's literally over 600 of you guys that voted here didn't know what this was. Please do watch up until the end to make sure that you are squeezing every bit of information you actually can from this video. Before we actually get into this, if you want to be familiar with the Google Analytics section, all you need to do to get to it is to firstly click on your logo, so your shop image, and then you want to click on account settings, followed by going on Google Analytics under the artist tool section. Now, if you do that, it'll take you to a screen that looks like this. And this is the point where you would have to go to Google Analytics to get your web ID that you can actually then paste in this section there. Once again, it's very simple to do and I'll be taking you through the steps. So if you need to, you can literally keep referring to this video till you get it right. Also, I don't know if many of you guys know this, but on the Redbubble Help Center, you can actually type Google Analytics setup and you'll be able to get all this information. And they pretty much show you how to set them up. You just have to read through the steps, follow them, and you can do it that way. I'm only showing you guys this because I know a lot of you guys learn better by, you know, just reading through something rather than actually watching a video. So I'll make sure to put a link to this down in the description. And for whatever reason, if you don't find a link, make sure to let me know down in the comments and I'll fix that for you guys. Right, so what you want to do is you want to go on account name to start off with and type Redbubble store. So this is literally when you're starting up the whole setup process. Once you do that, you want to click on Google products and services because it's not highlighted. Click next. At this point, you want to add a property name. So this could be anything. I just put here t-shirt store, so it doesn't have to be anything complicated. After doing that, you want to make sure that you set your time zone. Also want to make sure that your currency is set up as well. After that, you want to go into advanced options just there. And then after that, you want to make sure you turn on the universal analytics property. At this point, you want to go onto this section where you add the website and you just put redbubble.com, nothing more than that. Tick create universal analytics property only, bit long there. And then after that, you just want to fill in the business information. It's very simple. I clicked small on industry. I clicked shopping, as you can see there. And then on this section here, I just clicked to measure customer engagement with my site or app. Click create. On this point, you just want to make sure that everything is checked here. Once you're done, you click accept and then everything will pretty much be set up for you. This point, you don't have to tick anything. You just click save. Once you click save, you will have your website tracking number here. You want to copy that, jump over onto Redbubble, after you copy that, and then you'll actually be able to just paste it in on web property and then click save changes as well. Once you've saved your changes, you're pretty much good to go, and Google Analytics will now be able to track your Redbubble traffic. And moving on to why you should actually use Google Analytics, it allows you to track your customers' actions with your store. So if you have a certain design that's getting a lot of clicks, you will know. And this is actually highlighted through these blue boxes. If there's any active users on your page, you will see them here, and it usually shows you under top active pages which pages people are actually currently on. And it makes it really easy to track what's happening with your shop live. However, if you are looking to see how your shop's been performing over the past week or so, below where you'd find this blue section here, there's actually a section that will show you your most clicked pages. And you can actually track that to see which designs on what products people have been clicking on. The best way I recommend you guys to use this is to make sure that you're looking at the information you're getting on Google Analytics in regards of which products or which designs are getting the most clicks. And then you want to use that information to then make more similar designs. Because at the end of the day, if you keep making things that people are already looking for, you're going to further increase your traffic, which is going to lead to more sales. So yes, I feel it's very important, especially if you're trying to grow your shop, and even more important if you have no sales at all. So if you're watching this and you're on zero sales, definitely set this up if you haven't already. I hope this kind of updated tutorial has made it somewhat easier for you guys to be able to do that. Also, don't forget there's a link in the description that actually talks you through how to set it up if you want to go about it this way. And it's pretty much exactly what I showed you in the video, but it's written. So if you like reading, definitely check that out. It might make life easier for you. There's actually more, a couple of advanced Google Analytics settings. If you want to check them out, you can watch them in a video that I'll link here. I'll put it beside me or something. This was a video I made a little while ago, but I actually spoke about some of the advanced features a little bit more. As for today, I think I'll leave it here, guys. If you did enjoy this video, please do drop a like, as that would be very much appreciated. And if you made it to this point of the video, down in the comment section, comment down, all I need is data, because at the end of the day, data is what's going to help you bring in them sales. Anyways, thank you for watching. Always remember that everything is rigged in your favor, and manifest success.